and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we're going to have a producer discussion here on YouTube and around our, you know, Facebook and Twitter. And the question is, what do you think about the new Machine Jam? Usually I don't talk about new products because they're not interesting. But coming out soon, we have some really cool products coming to the music production community, and I think they're noteworthy. So the Machine Jam is kind of like a different version of the Machine Studio as a controller. It has like a multi-pad layout, as you can see in the video right ahead. I'm not really describing this from, you know, top of head. This is we're all watching the video right ahead of us. But as you can see, you know, there's multi-pads. There's like, you know, those on the new Native Instruments controllers, they have that touch pitch bend and touch mod wheel. They have a lot of those at the bottom of the controller, almost like a touch mixer for DJs. So it looks like they're marketing this towards DJs, and I think that's because Ableton Push is marketing their touchpad to producers, which is somebody who's composing, and also to DJs at the same time. It just reminded me of the Ableton Push, and the only real difference that I can see is the touch mixer stuff at the bottom. Now, the only thing I don't really like about Complete Controls, for example, is the pitch wheel, because on the on any keyboard, especially Korg, I really love their pitch wheel, that sideways pitch wheel. It really works because that's how people play. They don't play with the pitch wheel, you know, pushing up. It's a weird direction. But anyway, the pitch wheel on the controllers are touch, and it's just, when you compare touch towards a real pitch wheel, it's just not the same. You can't get the same type of emotion from your pitch wheel like you could with those hardware pitch wheels. But I understand it's trying to be innovative and push the hardware to the future. But that's one thing that I just really get turned off about with the Native Instruments controllers. It's just that touch pitch wheel. It just does not give you the same R&B type of vibrato effects that you're trying to create. You could kind of tap on the pitch wheel to do like a tap to that value type of thing, going from zero to that value. But again, it can sound very digital and very, you know, blocky, almost like a pulse wave type of shape rather than a sine wave type of shape. And those are just little things that just turn me off from the controller, even though I have two of them. I know I'm talking crap about it, but I have two Native Instruments controllers, and that's because I have two rooms, one's for Mac, one's for PC, but I want these to control my machine, and I didn't want to have to take this controller that doesn't really integrate in my one PC side to over to the other side, so, and get a new MIDI controller for no reason. So I just decided to get the same thing so I can integrate with my machine in the Mac side, because some weird issue happened where my machine stopped working with my PC. And I'm sure somebody else had that issue as well. And it's really weird, you know, there's no solution for it. I went to update machine and it just blue screened my computer. Now, another thing with machine is that for some reason on PC, my Complete Control VST and FL Studio just disappeared. I have not, or select, complete select, whatever it's called, VST just disappeared. And I can only open those options inside of machine, which is not how it used to be. It used to be like its own VST in FL Studio. So that's a major, you know, reason why I bought the controller and bought the machine, and it doesn't even work with my PC setup. So that was a big frustration, because the Machine Studio alone is $1,000, and you got the controller, which is $700, and then you got the, I think the software comes with machine, and then you got the expansions that you bought. So it's like $1,000. It's, you know, almost $2,000 for something that just doesn't work. And hopefully you don't experience that as well. Just keep precaution. But if you have a Mac, it should work fluidly. But for whatever reason, I'm not sure if it's the components of my PC or whatever, it just had weird conflicts. So that's my warning to you, not to overly invest if you, you know, I don't even know how to test it. You know, I'm not sure what caused the errors, but so anyway, I'm not going to dig into that long rabbit hole, but that was a major flaw. Because they sell it off of integration and it wasn't integrating. So that was like, what's the point? And even Superstar O said he had problems with it as well. So it's not just me, and I'm not just crazy. Okay, so here is The Machine Jam. Now let's look at how similar it looks to the Ableton Push. Now I will say Ableton Push is one of the most intuitive controllers I've ever used. I never read a manual. I never knew anything about it. I just opened it, plugged it into Ableton, and just started using it. And it's very, it's so intuitive that you don't need a manual right away. Now I'm sure there's some advanced functions and, you know, different things, but for the most part, it's straightforward and it gets straight to the point. Usually I don't praise a lot of products, but this one really is very intuitive. The buttons you think you should press are the buttons you press. There's no like hitting shift to do like some complicated function like a machine. You have to know all the shortcuts. And not saying machine isn't good, because I use it to make grooves and different, you know, ideas on the machine. And I'm not bashing machine at all. But again, that weird integration problem really did set stuff back. Now, if I didn't have a Mac, it would have went to waste. So that's another $2,000 on a Mac. So it's like, how much money do I need for this thing to work? So just be careful of that. So the Ableton Push is, we're watching like a little GIF, I guess, or video file of what's going on. Again, they went with that kind of touch pitch bend slash mod wheel control slash general kind of amount controller. I think that's kind of the way of the future, but again, it takes away something when you don't have that physical pitch wheel. And I think the pitch wheel should be just associated with MIDI controllers, MIDI keyboard controllers anyway, not these kind of DJ kind of touch elements. But when it comes to a MIDI controller, I think we can all agree that the physical pitch wheel does a lot better job than these kind of touch pitch wheels. I don't know who demanded this, but it just doesn't, for functionality's sake, it just doesn't make sense. Because we're not all trying to do pitch rises like EDM. You know, sometimes we're just trying to do a vibrato, you know, thing with our synths. So you can do a lot with Ableton Push. One thing that was cool about it was the pads are more intuitive, because on machine, for example, and I'm not trying to do this machine versus whatever. I'm just saying on machine, there are a set amount of pads, and the only way to play the notes are if you go up each pad one by one. In Ableton Push, there's so many pads that when you go up the pads, it's not a one by one kind of semitone setup. They set it up to where they have these key highlighted notes to let you know when you're playing your note, and also octaves. So in halves, I think they do. Let me see. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It looks like they mark the fifth and then they mark the octave, which is helpful because you want to know those perfect tones, and those are called perfect fifths and perfect unison. And what that means is those notes will always work together regardless. And another great thing about Push is that when you play a note, it shows you the note that you played while you're ascending up the keyboard or up the pad. So you know where you left off. And I know that sounds a little abstract until you use it, but that feature is something that was just something you probably wouldn't think about, but it's something you actually need. So what do you think about, you know, this design of Ableton Push versus, you know, the Machine Jam? It just feels like, you know, the pads are smaller. If you look at the pads, they're like micro pads. I can understand this is more for DJing, but it just seems like a weird product to release. And I think they released it to fight the Ableton Push. So here's what it looks like. I mean, it has even the same kind of arrow looking things. I don't know. This is what happens in music production, and this is why it's so important to be unique. The only difference between the Ableton and this is the major difference is the mixer knobs at the bottom. But how useful are they really? I mean, maybe in DJing. So maybe this just has tons of value for a DJ, because I know they sell Traktor controllers as well. So this is probably like a wonderland for DJs who play sets and different clips. So this is like a clip trigger thing. I don't know. I need to know what you think about it and how useful it is to you. So I think this is going to be extremely useful for DJs. Not sure how well it does in music production, but we will see. So this is, you know, I just don't know. It just reminded me immediately of Abel's and Push. But it doesn't really matter because we're probably going to get them both at the end of the day. So, I mean, it's not like a one versus the other. It just seems odd. So, let me know what you think. I'm scrolling through the pictures. That's why I'm not really commenting as much. And you can see the same kind of octave layout that they have in Ableton Push. So I don't know. And also, we might go over Complete Ultimate. I don't have it because I have Complete 10 Ultimate and it has all the instruments I want. So I don't, you know. I would need to see what comes new with 11. Let's see, what's new? Now, this is an aside. This is beyond the video. I'm just kind of digging into Native Instruments now because they released a lot of products that kind of went under the radar. I'm sure they did well, but you know, it didn't spark a huge revolution in the music industry as far as production. So let's see here. So we have, it looks like Una Corda, India Libraries, Brass Solo, Woodwind Ensemble, String Ensemble, and I can't tell what that library is underneath. Okay, so here are the new libraries in Complete 11 Ultimate. We have Symphony Essentials, which were like super expensive. It was like $300 for the brass one alone. I'm sure they're marketing these towards film composers and music, video composers rather than production, but I mean, rather than songwriting. Not sure what the form is. Native Instruments also released a lot of effects. I think, or synth. I forget what it is, but Reactor 6, that was pretty big when that hit. The only thing about Reactor is that it's just super complicated. Like it's on the level of computer nerd. Like you have to be a coding master to use half of these things to the full degree. And it's just, I mean, if you don't know everything about codes and maths and different things, it's just discouraging to even begin to use. But I think they added like a modular thing where you can add in components, so that maybe that makes it easier. But as far as coding and routing and all that, it's a whole different world. It's almost like, you know, computer programming at that point. Kontakt 5.6, I guess they allow more libraries. So Una Corda is one. Session guitarist, a lot of people have been asking for an acoustic guitar. VST that they like. I'm gonna have to investigate that one. I haven't heard it and I haven't used it yet. Then we had the India one. This did inspire me at the time, but I never got it. I think it's because I realized I had these sounds in Omnisphere or something. I forget why I didn't get it. I think I convinced myself that when am I ever gonna use Indian sounds? And that's not to be a racist comment. It's to say, do I really need these sounds? That's the question I had to ask. Then we have Emotor strings, which are similar to action strings, it looks like. Here's the plugin I was talking about, Flesh. It's kind of like these one knob type of plugins. I don't know what it does, but that's one of the things. And then Replica XT. Do I value these at, you know, the $400 upgrade or $300 upgrade? I don't know. I haven't used any, but I mean, nothing's in here that I necessarily am drooling over. If anything, I want to investigate the guitar. But a lot of sounds, you got to realize you have these sounds. But we're, as producers, we're always sound hunters. That's just our nature. So I'm not going to dig into Ultimate 11. It just caught my eye. So I'm going to wrap this up. But what do you think about the Ableton Push versus the Machine Jam? You know, what are your takes on this? And also, it's called Machine Jam, which means you use this in machine. So I've never used machine for DJing yet. So maybe it unlocks a new level to machine. I don't know. So let me know in the comments below what you think about it and how you think it can improve or what throws you off about it, or which one you like the best. So thanks for watching today. It's BusyWorksBeats.com.